Okay, let's do a quick video. Let's talk about drainage, surface water. Drainage, asphalt, 100%. Water runoff. Clay is about 100%. I think it's 75, but you can probably get it to 100 easily. Once it's saturated, then you're there. There's a sample I put out there. It was put out, and just as the product that came out of there. It's been out here overnight once it's rained. Let's scratch the surface. And it's still very plastic. Now let's break it. It might only be an eighth of an inch, if that much, before it was waterproof. Clay is awesome. I mean, they've got earthen dams. This earthen dams to hold back water is clay. It's an engineered mix. Not always, though. This ground is saturated right here. The soil, clay, soil, surface, right? Saturated. Now you can get a pipe, and actually that's a brick. Felt like a brick. Let's come here. So this, you can get a pipe, and you can drive a pipe in here 3 to 6 feet, take a sample out. So I can push through this with a stick. And let's go ahead and pull it out. I pushed through somewhere about there. This is still a pretty nasty clay. It's just giving you, you're just getting data. So temporarily, ran a French drain back there, and the water's being pumped out. Where's the water coming from? It's coming from the surface here. Asphalt, it can't go through the surface. I'm sorry, it's coming from the sky. It's, once it hits here, it comes to the soil, or surface here, the soil-looking surface, right? Hits this clay, it can't penetrate it. There is some crabgrass of a type that can grow on top of it. Can't penetrate it. It's pooling out here and causing total drama for the man. Let me go ahead and pause the video. I'm getting water on my phone here. Okay, I was getting water on my phone. I had to pause the video and see if I could hold him. Well, that was great. I just talked for about 10 minutes and nothing came of it. Let's go back to this. In other words, recording stopped. So the rain's coming from the sky. That's where rain comes from. Here's the driveway. The driveway is pitched towards me, but also that direction. I brought over some samples of some materials that you can do to get this resolved. Think of that as a gutter, this device right here. And you go the length from here to here, and you would re-divert the end of that. That gutter would have a downspout, basically. Think of it as a downspout. A redirect pipe over to the swale, which has inside of a corrugated, will have inside of a corrugated pipe that's going somewhere else to be lower part of the lower part of the street, or it's going to be pumped out to the street, one or the other. Okay, so back to this is a basin, just like you would see in a street, if you will, this little box here. We'll get over to it. The roof of the garage, though, this is the garage roof, has water running back to there. It works. It might be unsightly being on the outside. You can bury it. That works just fine. You bury it and get it over there. This is the other option. This is a flat profile product that you can run over to the swale, or you can run it back there to the gutter box, which would be the smartest move because it's closer and that's where it's going ultimately, and it won't overload this pipe with extra water. Same thing with this guy. You could tie into it across the front of the driveway here, coming back about a foot and a half or so, pitch from the driveway downwards into the gutter, back out to there again, back out to where you're going to pump it out of. Now, let's go over to the swamp. This is clay. Again, I think I did that clay part. I think that made it in the video. You could take a sample of this by grabbing a regular pipe, not PVC, a metal pipe. Cut it on a taper, drive it in 3 foot, 6 feet, pull it out and take a sample of what you have. You can cut the pipe, don't get really thick walled stuff. You can drive it circularly into the ground to get a core sample and cut your pipe, look at your samples and determine that what your soil levels look like at certain depths. You might find it's down 3 feet and you might, oh, that's it. And then you run into perfect soil. You're like, oh my gosh, I just need to remove 3 foot of soil and I'm in the perfect soil. Then that's awesome. Soil is about, it's a absorption rate, basically about 35% resistant. Let's see if I got that right. 100%, 35%, yeah, so 65% absorption. So here's the just our drain. I was informed the water was coming from this side. Turns out I think it's mostly coming from this side. And some over there for sure. Something's going on a little odd there. That's not just rainwater. I mean, that's not just rainwater from the sky. Something's being overloaded, saturated, and it's coming up. Ultimately, this water, earlier when I looked at it, was back to here, and now it's here. It will fill this gutter up, quotations, gutter up, and it will go, and you walk into this beautiful mud. So here's the basin. Let's turn around and look at that. You can get a corrugated pipe into it. You use the clay to your advantage now. You surface this to run to this. So the water now will run to here. Yeah, you'll have this smaller saturation. It all depends how great you are with your grading. But you'll have a smaller saturation if you grade it very well. Using the clay to redirect to your swale. Your swale comes around to your sump pump. Now we can see it's lower here, so this is obviously doing something here. That pumps out. That's pumping out for now. Machine tracks. So a lot of this water, I would say, is coming from the roof, the garage roof, and back, and before that's the level before the pump kicks in, what you're looking at. And it's not that deep. Don't think it's like a huge depth there. That's, you can see some of the daylight of the mud below it, mud, clay. So this is just surface pockets of water, rainwater. Ultimately, it will fill up and get over to there. You get this nice and even at the bottom. It's clay again. It's already impervious pretty much. You should add some stone or filter fabric. Some stone would be nice. A filter fabric. Add your stone. Put your pipe down there. Put more stone on top. Wrap your pipe. Wrap your stone. It's all into this area here. And that's just to keep the stone from being clogged up with clay. The issue with filter fabric is that filter fabric can also clog up with clay. So there's your issue. But the good thing is about this material and the amount of water that we have causing movement, I don't see it. It's not that. It's very tight still. It's not like it's it's a river or it's a flash flood. But yeah, the clay would then build up and then get pushed out of the way, and now it's a force upon itself. That's not an issue here. So I'm not worried about that, the soil becoming compressing into the filter fabric. I'd probably delete the filter fabric on this one. I'd just go with some big riprap, 3 to 6 inch riprap, and lay the pipe in there, into the riprap, and lay riprap on top, and then soil on top of that. Now, before you put the soil on top of the riprap, you'd put filter fabric, and then the soil, and we're talking about 6 inches of soil, whatever your grass is that it requires, 6 inches, 8 inches, so you would have to lower the swale down. It becomes impractical at some point, cost-wise. Cost prohibitive, right? That's what it's referred to. Because you're going to add all that soil there, 6 inches is not going to be cheap, and your end goal is to resolve the water. So maybe it is cost prohibitive. Maybe it's not cost prohibitive, depending on how much you hate the water. So there's your high point. There's your ponding area. There's a swale here, as you can see, but there's no water over here. This might be doing pretty damn well. There's the driveway far over there, so it has to cross all this. So we're looking at surface water that's being taken care of. And you probably take a core sample here. I'm walking on it. It's not squishy, washing, the basics. But then we look at things like this, and we see that's a scalloped area, right? It's no growth, but they had a plant back there that did like this one. And so the grass couldn't get water, couldn't get daylight. Surface couldn't get daylight, so nothing grew there. Same thing there. So don't confuse that with a water issue. It was more like a daylight issue. And again, you can see that, because you can see the plants been removed in the background. Now, they do have a downspout that's hitting the surface right there. That is going on to over here. By default, it has no choice. But to find equilibrium for that water, would be down here in this trench. We'd put it inside this box, run it on down, a box or something like that. Just wanted to leave this, show what this is about. I'll leave this here for the homeowner to look at, along with the other two. And we've got the high spot down there. I'm sorry, another low spot. Water would jump into the end of that little tail. Come on down here, and out it goes. I'm gonna pull this out though, so it doesn't get muddy. Just leave it on the surface. It's got connections in it, and it also has surface pop-ups. But surface pops up are not needed here. This is just my sampler that I take around to show what you can do for water issues. And that ends this video. Ask any questions you like. I can point you in directions. I'd probably tell you to look at one of the products, NDS. They have a few sites that will talk to you about it. You know, they trigger me when they talk about gravity. I'm like Einstein. I don't believe in gravity. I believe in equilibrium. Even NASA now is saying that they can't prove gravity. I think gravity is ridiculous. It's equilibrium, and that's another topic. This is not being held down by gravity.
Okay, the trench is full. Rain's coming from there over here drastically. Fill the trench up, and I'm sure the sump pump shut down. Okay, sorry about the handhold. You see the amount of water coming out of the pipe? Very minimal. Let's see if we can get the same results. Piers right here. There's the bit of a low spot right here. I can feel it in the pipe. There's our saturation. Now that's a pretty deep hole I made, so that's not going to be something you play around with. And feeling the soils, this is very expansive at this point. Very expansive, see it? Check it up here. Yes, very expansive soil. And out of here, yeah. So I'm gonna walk around and we'll take a look from the other side and get more data. You see the water's coming high, coming out of here now. We're going that direction, but it's the neighbor's property. It's got a ton of water coming off their roof. And I'm gonna walk into the swell here on purpose to see how compressible it is. It's not that bad. Pretty tight, in other words. Pretty tight. Okay, here we go again. So we see our low spots over there. Not here yet. Something interesting going on right there. Most of the water's from the neighbor. And surface water from this guy too, but I think maybe the pump shut off. We'll find out. Right now, I'm just going to feel how soft it is underneath my feet. Pretty good. Let me walk up right up to the edge. See if it gives. Not much. But she's filled in. And these pumps, either working or it's not working. I can't tell. So there we have it. The trench is almost maxed out. You see the water still below the rim of the trench, basically, all the way everywhere. And I don't know if this pump is working or not. I don't, you know, maybe it's continuously on right now. I don't know, but the volume is too great for the pump at this point, or the pump is off. It's going out to the front, out to the street. This is just ruts, tie ruts. But looking for other sources of water back here. It's coming from back there, even working its way towards here. That's interesting. That ground is also saturated. The ground behind him is saturated. All saturated. Adding to his dilemma. Might be a Yeah, there's a lot of that water saturated. See the water still showing itself like a pond. And looks like it's got a little pathway right there. I'll do it again and you see where it originates from. Starts coming out the top. So that's a pathway for water from that neighbor coming over here. So he's getting it from neighbor after neighbor, it looks like. And back there even, it's working its way over. Oh my God, this is really saturated. Did you see the path? So there's that source. All of that source there too. Working its way downhill. And downhill, it's not looking good for him. Let's look, it's over here. We need some of this clay to make a little cofferdam, make a little dam to keep some of it back. Put that clay on this side between his property lines. Put a dam up over here. It's pretty nasty. Over here we have water coming out there. And that's on three roofs on the neighbor's property. And that just works his way over to here. And on the crook, can't quite see the path. Can't quite see the path, but that's not just disappearing. So we can see the three points right there, right in the middle, which is here, and a path coming that way, all making it down to his flood zone. Yeah, his pump went off. His pump went off, it's dead. It's the, where it's clogged. The, it's not moving. There we go, back on again. Kicked his pump back on. His float turned around and got stuck. So now let's see how badass it is. Looks like it's pretty badass. It's working pretty aggressively. Let's see how much time it takes to move that out. And we can all see the water, the high parts of the water while we're back here. A lot of water's got to move, but let's see how it does it. How does she make out? I'm going to time the camera out and we'll start back over. And I'll watch the rim, the water level drop. See, it's still on. I can see the pump, hose. Vibrating. He's flowing.